portfolio, showed it to other people online, talked to me for a half an hour, changed my life. There's no way I walk out of there and not be a comic artist or a comic person. That was it. And he corresponded with me a couple times. He sent me Andrew Lucas' book on anatomy, and it changed my life. And then years later, and I waited like 15 years to come up to him with Jinx. I came up to him with Jinx, and I said, "Listen, when I was a kid, it changed my life, and I'm trying not to bother you all these years, but I just won an Eisner a couple days ago, and because of you, and thank you, and now, so he changed my life then, and then now that I know him, and I've seen him, and we actually ended up at a con in Australia for 3 weeks together, and I got to see, he is absolutely everything I want to be to the readers, as a creator. He draws as if he is someone 30 years younger than himself. He is nothing is stopping him, and I'm so blown away by it. It's so classy and cool. It's so nice. And even on our message board, I try to do it. Be Walt Simonson every day. Just be Walt Simonson. And Howard Jacobs, the same thing. Just like he's like an elder statesman now. He's really enjoying it. I was like, man, just be cool.
Yeah, just be classy.
These guys online, I see them all the time. They're not classy, and they're not cool. They're fighting with each other. You guys don't talk about it. And I go, just, but we spend more time paying attention to that because it's fun to watch. It's, but if you get to meet Walt Simon or someone like that, just wow, just really changed my whole life. And everyone I'm here, that's all I think about is be Walt Simon.
What specifically is it like that you most hear stories of people, like stories you've had, everyone has it.
Archie has that
story.
But there's still huge, other generations still producing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, to Walt and Jamie shared a studio together.
Yeah. Yeah.
229 West 29th Street.
Do you remember with them? Was Miller with them?
Miller and Alan Weiss.
It was just a scary, scary.
Yeah, so you had in one room American flag, Silence in the Store, and Ronin being produced simultaneously. In one room.
And we're on Xbox shooting.
Yeah. I don't know, maybe fear they should fight the Lapnus.
Go ahead, sorry. I was just gonna say there's a private wearing suit swapping on the thing.
Evan has the worst headset. Anytime you talk to him, he'd be playing everyone here fine, and he's like, it's very odd being able to actually understand what Evan's saying.
But going back, continuing what you said there about the Simonson and Chaikin and Miller and Weiss together. With what we said,
still good start.
I was trying to think of what Alan Weiss was doing. Going back to what I was talking about earlier, like the virtual bullpen, the virtual studio. We have a lot of virtual studios around. The guys that you see their names together as, we're in a studio. Like, you live near each other. Do you think you can still see that same kind of synergy? And that's even, I guess, arguably to say that Thor influenced American Flag, influenced Ronin, all.
You can see the sound effects. Alone, you can tell their music text was very much everybody's looking at everybody else's show.
Yeah.
And seeing how far you can push it. But it's funny, when they have us up at Thor Retreats, you spend like half a day at the Marvel offices, and then the other 2 days or 3 days, Marvel is tend to be off site. They rent a large meeting space that can accommodate like 30 or 50 people. But everybody's really excited for that day at Marvel because it's the closest thing to the old, even though it's not the same building, but it's like you go down the hall and see everybody's offices, and that's the closest. You kind of want to show up in like shirt sleeves and a tie just to kind of smoke cigarettes and put them out.
We're all really excited about everybody at Marvel.
They get
all the art for the upcoming books on the wall.
Yeah.
All the covers are on clipboard.
Yeah.
See, what I also like about the bullpen is that everyone has a bulletin board that they shit on it and making fun of creators.
Yeah.
But they always take it down. Clearly, we're not, they have to be captured about us.
Yeah, I'll totally
go in there like
patches on the board.
Except the next one is on, so actually has pumpkins with Xeroxes of people behaves. Bowie nice stabbing a Friday pumpkin.
There's another editor who hates an editor who hasn't worked there in 20 years, and his whole desk is like a, it's like a voodoo.
There's an editor there who, when we were at one particular meeting, brought up today is the end of the 23rd anniversary or whatever it was of so and so being fired at 3:18 p.m. I set the alarm on my iPhone, so during the meeting it went off, I'm like, and the moment has passed. Every year, like it's the 26th anniversary or whatever.